How do you start overcoming your sexual shame?
In general, I assume when you're saying kind of repressed, it's about sexuality and flirting. I think the big answer is to understand that sexuality and human connection and intimacy is not something to be ashamed of. It's as human, when you look at psychological needs, right? It's as human as water, air, shelter, food, and then there's intimacy right there. Going after that is also human. It's about if, you know, a woman doesn't like you back or she's not interested, accepting that and letting go rather than continuing to flirt with her and be sexual. That's where I think it gets weird. So first off, understand that it's healthy. We all want it. If you want a romantic connection, we need to express that. I think on a practical level, you got to find small ways to express your sexuality or your interest in women. Like I said, let's give an example of giving a really bold compliment, telling a woman you find something attractive about her or sexy or cute or beautiful, or that you really find that an attractive quality in a woman. A lot of guys have a hard time saying that. You got to find a small way to do that. Even if it's not on a date, let's say you're doing online dating and you're starting to message a woman, practice saying that one time. Maybe you're texting a woman, and even if you're going to lose that opportunity, you got to get comfortable with what you want, because confidence is always going to be the most attractive thing. So you say, okay, I've been talking to this girl. I really like this about her. I'm going to find a way to tell her this over text and express my interest, express my sexuality. And that exposure is what builds in our mind. It's okay. And especially when you see a woman respond warmly to it and give it back to you, and you say, hey, I think it's so attractive that you're really ambitious. And she says, hey, well, I think you're really funny and cute. Then that internalizes, okay, why am I ashamed of this? If it's normal and she likes it, some women will be interested, some won't. Everyone wants sex deep down, or intimacy. But it reinforces, like, well, it can't be that bad if a lot of women are responding to it and enjoy it and want to engage back with me. And finding small ways to do that. Another way is eye contact. Guys have a hard time making eye contact with a woman across the room or on a date or something, because it's basically saying, if I look at a woman at a coffee shop and we meet eyes and I hold eyes with her and smile, I'm signaling I'm interested in you. I might want to get to know you. And that scares a lot of men because there's that repression. And I think practicing and saying, okay, I'm going to go out today. I'm going to sit in a coffee shop, for example, and if I catch eyes with a woman that I find attractive, I'm going to hold eye contact for a few seconds longer than I normally would. Or I'm going to hold eye contact until she breaks it first, because most of the time I see her and I kind of duck my head, right? And every time you do that, you're telling your brain, be ashamed. Being sexual, showing interest is wrong. And you need to train your brain that it's not. You make eye contact with a woman, you smile, and sometimes she's going to smile back. And sometimes she's going to look down and be a little nervous and look back and smile at you. And it's those little moments to get comfortable showing interest over text, in person, on dates, complimenting, physical contact, that reinforces sexuality is okay and lots of women will like it too. But start slow. If you can't do a big gesture of going for a kiss on a date, you don't need to. Practice little things and kind of work your way up.